Cinema 5D at Interb 2018 is brought to you by MusicBed. Discover a better sound for your project. Canon. Live for the story. And Cartoni. Supports your vision.
Hi, I'm Johnny from Cinema 5D, and I'm here with Carly from Astro. Carly, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm always good. What's the choice in life? Carly, but we're not here to talk about my life. We're actually here to talk about Astro, and Astro is presenting a new camera, which looks very much, at least from the outside, the body looks very much for the cinema market. Mm-hmm. I mean, up until now, you've been doing a lot of things for the broadcast world. So tell me a little bit about this camera.
So this camera actually is not a proper product yet. So this camera, we have a cube camera, which is similar in design to this, but smaller, that we have, you know, we have a couple versions of that previously. So this is sort of the next step up from that camera, where that one didn't allow you to operate right on the actual camera itself. You'd had to have a separate CCU and remote control. This camera has the controls built in, and we're not really sort of aiming for a particular market with this camera. It's sort of the next evolution of that smaller cube camera. And we've brought it here this year to Interb in order to hear from people what kind of ways that they think that they could use this camera. We've designed this camera to be able to meet a lot of different kinds of needs. So it's not specifically for just broadcast. You know, people who are in maybe the movie industry or documentaries or things like that would be able to use a camera like this.
So I see you're a bit cautious, but on the other hand, this is as close as it can get to a final product, or this is still on developing stage?
This is still in the development. It's not quite a final product yet, so we are still listening to our customers and seeing what they want. And if we get enough requests for a certain way of doing something or something people want to change, it is still possible to change it.
How about the sensor inside? Is that your own creation, your own specifications, or you're kind of collaborating with other companies? Usually making a sensor is not that cheap.
Our sensor in this case is something that we bought from another company to put into the camera.
When it comes to the color science, do you have your own color science? Or again, this is a part of a cooperation with another company?
In terms of color science, that is something that we do in-house, yes.
So this camera will have a flat gamma log recording option?
Yes, this will have a flat gamma log recording option as well as an HDR recording option.
Okay. You said that this product is still in under development.
Yeah.
But if it will see the day of light, about pricing, just ballpark?
We don't really have a price yet. We're still thinking about it. There's a chance it might go over, if you were going to say dollars, let's say US dollars. It may be around 100,000 US dollars. It may go over. We're not
sure. I'm sorry that I went like this. That's kind of my instinct. Okay, so.
There's no real set price yet. It's still very much in development because we're still listening to people and what they want. And depending on how the product changes in the future, it'll greatly affect the price.
So it sounds more like either a rental house product or for broadcasters in the sense of budget, not necessarily, you know, it's not for the independent filmmaker probably.
Yes, definitely. Unfortunately, 8K still being the new technology that it is, even though the products and the pricing has gone down in recent years, it still is quite a pricey technology for people who don't have, you know, big budget backing.
Carly, thank you very much. Thank you very much for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.